Hi! In this video, I will show you how to make a 3D copy of an object with your phone and Autodesk ReCap photo. It's a beginner's tutorial. Welcome to my YouTube channel Green Eyed Explorer, where I explore further and beyond. Hi! Today I will show you how to make this little seashell copy. Steps are simple. Things you will need: a high resolution camera, a smartphone is enough, PC with 64-bit Windows, and some patience. Let's get to it. I put a chair next to the window to get the natural light, put a colorful book on the chair and a seashell on the top. Here are some of the photos I took. After taking them, copy all pictures to your hard drive. We will have to upload them onto Autodesk servers. Installing Autodesk ReCap. First, enter www.autodesk.com into browser. Let's find ReCap. First, you will have to download Autodesk ReCap program. You can get the ReCap or ReCap Pro. Let's compare them. As you can see, the major difference is the ReCap Pro includes ReCap Photo program, which we will need. You can buy the Pro version or you can try the 30 days trial version. I will use the trial version. Let's download it. It requires 64-bit Windows operating system. Proceed. Let's select individual. Leave English. Let's select some company name. Phone 123456. Let's say we are from China and select the province. Enter zip, click next. Now download the program and install it. The program installs some icons on your desktop. Run the ReCap Photo. Creating 3D object. In ReCap Photo, click Create 3D object. Click the icon to upload images. Select them. In my case, Shell Photos folder. In current example, there are 46 images. Click Create. Select project name. I'll enter Shell Demo. A very handy option is Autocrop. Select it. It will preserve us some time afterwards. Click Start. Now you can see the photos are uploaded to my cloud. We will have to wait. Here you can see the end result. After the download, we will get the .rcm file on our drive. Here is the cut object I have shown you at the start of this video. My cloud drive has 25 GB capacity. After the upload, you have to wait in the queue with your order. In this video, I clipped sequences. In reality, I waited 1 hour for the process to finish. So, wow! It is finished! So soon! Click download icon. Select folder, save. Wait for it. It appeared under my computer. Let's click our newly saved model. I'll zoom in and rotate it a bit. It is cropped, but it will need some additional work. On the left we have a menu. Select Edit, Slice and Fill. Select No Fill. As you can see, a cutting plane appeared. If we are on the outer side of the circular plane, an up and down arrow icon appears. With your mouse you can move the plane up or down. Crop with clicking Apply button. We will have to repeat procedure several times. When you are on the inner side of circle, a two ellipse mouse icon appears. It means we can rotate the XYZ planes. In the end, we have a hole in the bottom. Let's fill it. By going to Edit, Fill Holes, we select appropriate tool. Let's zoom in and select one of the bottom triangles. Click Flat. This can take some time. I'll rotate it a bit to show you what we have. The bottom edges are a bit sharp. You can smooth it by going to Edit Surface Tools Smooth. Brush size is too large, I'll reduce it. Now let's click the bottom edge all the way around. Press Commit in the end. Let's make another overview. There are also other tools. Here is one for detecting and fixing errors. I'll click it. Well, that's good, no defects. Export options are image, video or model. Let's get the STL file for our 3D printer. Nice option here is to lower objects' faces. If you want precise .1 layer print, leave faces intact, otherwise experiment. Slicing the model. I will not print the model, but I will slice it in the Repetier host with Cura Slicer. First, let's enlarge the model. In reality, it is 7 times larger. Zooming in to show details. Firstly, I'll slice into 0.3 mm layer height. I selected 10% infill. Let's see more details. You can see most are lost. It would be a rough print. Next, I'll slice into 0.1 mm layer height. Before the screen update, we will see a glimpse of 0.3 mm layer height. 0.1 mm layer height preserves more details. Cutting edges and supports. Here you can see supports Cura makes to level out object. If you slice it in one plane at the start, the print will look smoother at the bottom in the end. It is up to you to decide. If you find this tutorial educational, please hit like, share video with your friends, comment below and subscribe to my channel.